Hey guys, how you doing? JP Sarikolia here, and I want to say to all of you, thank you very much for your support. As some of you know, I've been dealing with an ear infection since last week, and it's been really, really painful. I'm taking a lot of antibiotics and I'm taking medication. I'm supposed to be resting, but things are piling up and I don't want things to pile up on me. So I want to really react to a lot of stuff because companies don't stop. They don't sleep. There's a lot of releases this week and we have a lot of stuff coming too. So I want to cover today four different companies, four different products that I think people are interested in, and I will have the timestamps for those who are only looking for a particular collectible. So I want to start first with Iron Studios because I think this company, it's amazing what they're doing with the X-Men versus Sentinel collection. They have a Quicksilver R-Scale 110 Marvel Comics. I think the price is fantastic, $159.99. It is, I think, a really good entry point. Now you can pay all up front and you can choose the payment plan. It's supposed to deliver on December 31st of 2021, but it's always subject to change. Now this piece is extremely, extremely dynamic. I really love the classic depiction of Pietro here. I love the classic suit, the one that has been for years, and I think people don't really change much because it doesn't need to be changed. I love that. And the depiction, the work, the sculpt is phenomenal. I really love that, and it's so dynamic without being cheesy. In the case that they did it here, very simplistic, it does really represent his power, his mutant power, which is running at a fast speed. He's super fast. And I really love the way it's done. It's very natural the way he's running. It's not overly done. It's not crazy. There's no crazy pose. It's a natural pose. Love the anatomy. It's really good. And that face, that portrait, it is really nice. Pietro has been involved with the X-Men. Yes, he has. But also he has been involved, from the beginning with the Avengers. So I don't know if this is the next thing that Iron Studios is going to do. If they're going to cover an Avengers diorama, which be super, super nice. I would love to see that. But they did a terrific job with it. I love this, the simplicity of the piece, but also it's so dynamic. The anatomy is spot on. Look at that anatomy. The paint job is really, really cool. Love that. I think on this one, it is a really nice piece. I've seen some kinds of people saying that they would love for this to be a larger scale, like a 1/4 or 1/3. But I gotta be honest, I love the fact that Iron Studios is really covering this scale in such a loving way that I feel that it deserves that. You know, everyone deserves something. Not everything has to be a particular scale. I think it is good that we have this variants all over for all the scales. And I think Iron Studios is really becoming, it is the king right now of the 110 scale. I don't think there's other competitor right now. So I feel that this is good for the company. And they have done a terrific job with this one. Love the expression. He's running. I love that. The way he's doing it. I think they did a terrific job. Maybe there's some, concerns in regards to leaning at some point because everything is held by this. But man, this is a very cool looking piece. And at every angle, it really represents that. The potential is here. This is a better pose than any other poses that I've even seen from larger pieces, more expensive pieces for Flash too. You know, it's a very, very good pose, very good sculpt. They did a terrific job with this one. Here we can see this for reference on the scale. It is a perfect 110. I'm telling you, it is a good piece and I recommend it. All right, and now we're moving on to PCS. They have released a 1/3 scale Iron Man statue. Based on the Gamerverse, on the newest Avengers video game. And I'm telling you, a lot of people are talking about it. There are two different versions. There's a collector's edition, which is the regular version. You can find that not only at SciShow, but other retailers. And the exclusive. We're going to look at the exclusive. The price for this is $1,950. And this is really scary just from the get-go. Just the price alone, I think it is, in my opinion, it is too much for this piece. Even though it is in line with what the Gamerverse is all about and the cost for previous pieces like Venom Pool or Deadpool, I still feel that this is too much. Now, there's no edition size yet. This is, according to this, is going to be delivered or released around October and December of this year. All right, we don't have information about the painter or the sculptors for this piece, so my apologies if I don't mention it. It wasn't there. It was not in the information. Now, I really like the piece. I'm not denying it. I really like this Iron Man. I think it's really cool looking, and I really love this exclusive version because of the colors, and I feel that it's better than just the regular one. I love the depiction. I would say it is not the best looking armor in comparison to the other armors. I think even the MCU has better armors, but you're into more like the comic style. I think this is better. So you're a one-third collector. I'm just still feel that the price on this, it is really, really high in comparison to other products out there in the market right now. There's plenty Iron Man, and yeah, they're always pricey because of all the stuff that you add up to it. But I just feel that this is something that they need to be aware of on this in this end. Plus, you don't have switch out parts on this one, which is a shame. So technically, you're paying just for what you see. What you see is what you get right here. And not necessarily at that price point is convincing for a lot of people. But yeah, it is cool looking. I love the paint job. I think it's a great design. The base, I think, works with what they're trying to achieve. This is going to be really, really tall because of it. You got the light up features. It has a light up feature on the base, which is really cool. I'm not trying to diss the work of PCS. I think they do a terrific job. I just feel that the price, it is up there, and it's going to make it harder for some collectors to get into this one or to be even interested with other options out there. So yeah, I think that's the biggest problem with this piece. It is nice looking, but the price is not the best. All right, now we're moving on to Queen Studios. They just released a Vision life-size bust based on Avengers Infinity War, and it looks terrific. People are excited for Vision. Of course, he's a popular character. He has always been. I think more now through the MCU and also WandaVision, people are really excited for the character. And this bust delivers, in my opinion. Now, it's not available through the Queen Studios website here in the United States, but you can go through other retailers. I was looking this morning at Spec Fiction. It seems that they don't have it right now there. Perhaps it was sold out, but you can always email them and they will let you know if they will have more. There are other retailers that you can look to. But if you pay the deposit, it's $300 plus $715 and the shipping costs. Now you can do the full payment, which is $1,015. It is made out of polished stone. It has internal lighting, which is good. The edition size here, as you can see, is 398 pieces. So it's extremely, extremely limited. That's the reason why if you want it, you need to act fast. And this is going to deliver, according to the website, on the first quarter of next year. Now we're looking at the pictures here, and I like it. I think that the depiction is very natural. Queen Studios does terrific work with this one. On this pieces, you can see this one right here. Really cool. It's simplistic, and I like that. Even though it's polished, Sony does have some mixed media material, I think, if I'm not mistaken, with this. Yeah, with this cape, as you can see. It's not the best looking cape. I'm not so sure if that's actually accurate too. So I would say that that's perhaps the only thing that looks kind of cheap in comparison to the rest. I can even tell you that they can do without. You know, you can remove it, and I think people will be fine with it. But the eyes, man, the likeness with Paul Bettany is just there. It looks like him for sure. So they did a terrific job in representing the not only the character, but the actor. And look at the eyes, too. Very cool looking piece, man. At every angle, I like it. So I think now, with the MCU, with WandaVision, I think Vision has become really, really popular. And the popularity continues to grow. And I think they're capturing this really, really well. It's a standard base. I think it works good. I think it works better than other things they have done before. Like the Iron Man statues that they just did that I cover in this channel too. I think they look better like that. But yeah, at every angle, you can see they're the same pictures. I'm telling you, this is a nice looking bust, to be honest with you. It is pricey, but I think that price is fair in comparison to other pieces. So yeah, I would say this is a good one. So if you need it, if you want it in your collection, then you need to act fast. All right, and now we're coming to the last piece on this video, which is the Weta Workshop Darkseid 1/4 scale limited edition of 600 pieces. This statue looks terrific. It looks amazing. It is based on the Zack Snyder's Justice League. So they use that representation, that scene with Darkseid. It is the same thing. It's just a digital rendering of that. And they have done a terrific job in really representing that. Now, this is not for the faint of heart. This is not for the ones that are really concerned about price because it is $1,400. You can choose a payment plan, but still, it's very, very steep. The sculptor here is Gary Hunt, one of the most veteran sculptors, digital sculptors at Weta. Now, when we look at the piece, this is really, really huge. Now, this comes with this banner in the back. This is very, very tall. I don't know if you have the space. You have to have an empty wall for that. The base is huge, so you're gonna need a lot of real estate to really display this one. So this is one thing where I feel that not most collectors can afford it. Not necessarily because they cannot afford the price. I do feel that many cannot afford the space. That's another thing. I think it's, you know, space is money. And I feel that that's another thing that adds to the cost of this one, because you need to have an empty wall just to have that banner right there, which is cool. I think they're just part of the exclusive, and just to display like that. And that looks super cool. You don't have to have the banner, but man, it looks really good in my opinion. I'm telling you, the piece looks amazing. Look at this. I love the depiction here. I think they, in this case, Zack Snyder did a terrific job in depicting Darkseid, the way that it really comes across really menacing in the film. I feel that we need to see him more. Hopefully, they continue the Snyderverse. I cover that on my podcast because I think it deserves it. And I would love to see more of this Darkseid on cinema for sure. Now, again, you know, we're looking at renderings here. It would be nice when we get to see this in videos, you know, when Weta is able to produce that so we can see the prototypes. I love this pose, the thinking, Darkseid. It's another facet that most, I would say most companies don't cover, because they always present the way he's standing, he's laughing or smiling, or he has this evil attitude. He is more, I wouldn't say complacent, but I think he's just analyzing the situation. And I feel that this is a very good piece to have as a standalone piece. I think it works like that really, really good. I just wish there was more detail also on the base, but of course, this is based on the film. It wasn't there, and definitely needs more color. But it's based on the film again, and if you're familiar with Snyder's work, he loves this really earthy, kind of dark tones, and I feel that this covers that well. Again, the base is huge. Other thing that I need to mention, this has a light up feature in the eyes, which is really, really cool. Superman also did. I did not mention that in that video, but it does have a light up feature. That's another extra, and that also added to the price. Of course, the light up feature here is very small because the eyes are there, but it's cool that he has it. And they come with some plaques that says the Justice League, Zack Snyder Justice League, and I think the name of the character as well. I still prefer Sideshow's classic depiction. I love the modern depiction of XM, but this is very different. And I think we can applaud Weta for doing something very different. But what is your opinion? What do you think about these pieces? What do you think about Quicksilver? What do you think about Iron Man? What do you think about Vision? What do you think about Darkseid? Let me know in the comments below. But before I go, I want to say to all of you, thank you very much for the support. Don't forget to like, to comment, and to subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification button so you're reminded of every video. Follow me on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. The links are down below. And also consider supporting this channel financially through Patreon. Everything you can do to help really allows me to produce more content for you on a daily basis. My friends, thanks for watching. God bless. Take care. And I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.